Hello again, Adam here. Guys, today I'd like to tell you a bit about my journey to Atmel and Atmega programming. So, as you can see, these are my first projects here. So, these are digital thermometers, and one of them is also a humidity meter. So, whenever you want to start with Atmega or Arduino, whatever you call it, you would like to do something that is useful at your home, so I chose to do thermometers. And if you wish to do it, you would probably like to select some appropriate sensor, temperature sensor. So there are two types of sensor currently on the market. So one of them is a analog sensor, which is LM35 or TMP36. So LM35 is an analog sensor that will turn the temperature into the voltage, analog voltage, and then you have to do the analog to digital conversion. It also is widely used on the PC boards, for example. So whenever you have a PC board nearby the processor, there is a LM35 sensor. So I have a short description from the manufacturer. So it has a quite good accuracy because it's 0.5 Celsius and is calibrated by default in the factory. It also has a possibility to be switched to be a full range temperature sensor, I mean to measure the negative temperatures. So to do it, you have to put a resistor over here. Anyway, that's the first kind of sensors. The second one is a digital one wire sensor type. So these are widely available on the market from Chinese providers. And this one is named DHT22. So this one is capable to measure negative temperatures and also the humidity. And there's also another version of this named DHT11. The DHT11 is only used in weather stations that temperature meters that are inside the building. So this one is only capable to measure temperatures over zero, so from 0 to 100. So on the left side you can see a digital thermometer and humidity meter based on this sensor, so digital. On the left side you can see a thermometer based on TMP36, so this is a kind of similar to LM35, but it also enables you to measure a negative temperatures. And also the chip that is used here is connected to the old Nokia 5110 LCD, so this is only available as a kind of, I would say, Arduino interfaces. On the left side I'm also using a 4-digit LED display. This is the one that I have. So from the manufacturer we can see that this model is TM1637. What else do you need? In my thermometers I'm using some small chips named ATtiny. So I don't know if it's visible here, but I will try to use a magnifying glass. Whoops. Anyway, you have to believe me that this is the one. This is ATtiny 13. It has only 1 kilobyte of memory. Also, to drive this kind of LED displays, you need some bigger current, and that is why I'm using a linear voltage stabilizer LM7805, and also some diodes to protect the chip from inverted voltage, and some some small capacitors just to block interference between ground and voltage. Okay, so if we're talking about the sensors, so the first one, the analog, I have already shown, and the second one would be the one from the Chinese vendors. This is DHT22, but also named Aosong AM2302. There are plenty of vendors making the same kind of sensors. So this one is quite nice because it has better accuracy, and it also has a humidity meter. So if we look into the specs, we can see that it uses some kind of proprietary protocol to send the data. So it sends 16 bits for each information, for the humidity and temperature, and on the fifth byte is a parity information. So the interfacing is quite simple because it's using only one wire and the powering lines. So the VCC, GND, and the SDA is the line that is sending this digital information. So the minimum pads needed are only two. So you need to have a sensor and you need to have a microcontroller. But to make it right, there are also linear voltage put here and some capacitors and diode. Okay, so to see the schema, the schematic, it looks quite easy. So you just have to connect the microcontroller over one line to the sensor. On this picture we have DHT11, but it's also valid for DHT22. The linear stabilizer, the capacitors that are blocking the interference, and the LED display. For the first thermometer, and for the second one it's even simpler. So this second one on the right side, it's powered from two batteries, 1.5, so it's 3 volt, and the schematic looks like this. So it's even simpler than this, than the first one. So it drives the LCD display from old Nokia phone, which was basically disassembled. And that's all. Okay, there are many questions I'm receiving from you, how to program the chip, actually. So it is not Arduino exactly, but the chips are quite the same, but without using a bootloader. So if you want to program the chip without the bootloader, I'm using something like this. This is a USB ASP programmer, so it has 10 pins on the back, to which you connect some kind of cable, to which you have to attach the chip. So I made myself a board just to not to to connect again and again the chip. Just I'm putting chip here and then I'm programming. But if you would like to see how it is connected actually, so some pictures might be useful. So these are lines that are available in the programmer, and you have to attach them to the chip like this. So this is for ATtiny 13 or ATtiny 85 or some other chips that have only 8 pins. but you can also program an ordinary Atmega chip from the Arduino Uno, and to do it you have to connect like this. Anyway, so it is quite easy to do. There's a lot of information on the internet how to do it. So let's try to program a chip. So I'll put it to my universal board. Here, this one is a 8013. It's probably not visible because anyway, let's connect it to the PC. So I have a Linux PC, but it can be also with Windows, but you need to follow the guide that will describe how to install AVR GCC environment, so the environment that will allow you to compile C source codes for these chips and build them and upload them over this USB ASP programmer. So for example, if I would like, I've already attached this one here. So if I would like to compile and program the chip, I made some kind of batch scripts, so let's display them. So maybe I will select the code that is for this thermometer with DHT22. Let's display the code and the script that is doing the compilation. Okay, so it basically launches AVR GCC environment with configured for the appropriate for the particular chip, selecting a compilation compilator, doing the some kind of would say middle file, and then it is uploading compiled program to the chip and flashing it. So if I do it like this, it will make the compilation. So now I'm putting, so as you can see, it successfully uploaded to the chip. If I do it the same once again, we will see the LED blinking on the programmer, which is indicating that it is right now uploading the data to the chip. There are several packages that you need to install on the PC to make it work with the USB ASP, but there are also widely available tutorials to do it, so I will share with you some information on my GitHub page, and probably that would be sufficient if you go one by one. Okay, so I think that's all for today. So have a good work with these chips. So like I said, these are not exactly Arduino, but the 8Tiny line. So one of them, 8Tiny 85, can be modified, and it's even sold as an Arduino with appropriate bootloader, so you may look for it on the web and then reprogram it as you wish. You can remove the bootloader and use a USB ASP programmer to do to upload the source code. So have fun. Okay, thank you very much, subscribe and bye bye.